Greetings, everyone, and welcome to Art Vids for Kids. My name is Wendy, and I am a museum guide at the Dayton Art Institute. Today, we are going to look at a sculpture entitled Lost and Found by the artist Alison Saar. First, let's talk about how this artwork is different from other types of art forms found in the museum. What is a sculpture? How would you describe a sculpture? If you said it is three-dimensional, meaning it has length, depth, and height, you are correct. If we were looking at this artwork in the museum, we would be able to walk around it and view it from all sides and angles. Next, let's take a minute and look closely at this sculpture. What caught your eye first? Was it the long, flowing hair that connects the two figures? What material do you think the artist used to make the hair? The hair is actually made from wire, and it connects one person to the other person, creating a feeling of energy, almost like electricity. Maybe your eye was drawn to the two bright red wooden chairs. Did you see the words lost and found on the back of the chairs? Now look carefully at the bodies of the two figures. Did you notice that they are identical and made from metal? The artist took old tin ceiling tiles that had been removed from old buildings and used it to shape the bodies. The original ceiling tiles had a design stamped into them, which gives this sculpture an interesting look. Many of Alison Saar's sculptures use this type of metal tile because she likes the texture, and it helps her to tell her stories. What story do you think this sculpture is trying to tell? Now, I want you to pause the video and imitate the position of these figures. Be sure to bend at the waist and place your arms and hands in the manner in which the artist has molded her figures. Did this affect the feeling that you get from the artwork? Alison Saar is a living African-American artist who likes to tell stories with her art. She works with multimedia, which means that she makes art using many different materials, such as metal, carved wood, and paint. Alison Saar's work is usually about females, African-American experiences, and is often based on history. When Ms. Saar came to the Dayton Art Institute while the sculpture was being installed or placed in the gallery, she was asked about the meaning of this artwork. She replied that she wanted everyone to be able to make up their own story about lost and found, which adds to the interest of the artwork. Everyone gets to make their own story, and no ideas can be wrong. If you would like to see Lost and Found for yourself, please visit the Dayton Art Institute, Gallery 201. Thanks for joining me, and be sure to check back next month for more Art Vids for Kids.